This tutorial will show how to configure the navigation sidebar in Google Sites. By default, almost all Google Site templates come with a navigation sidebar located to the left of your website. This is populated with all of the pages that you've created, and while when you initially create new pages, you have some control over this in that, do you want the page to be at the top home level, or do you want it to be a subpage of another? Google organizes this for you alphabetically. However, if you would like to specify a specific outline for your pages, or you would like to have some pages not be visible in the sidebar, you can customize it to meet those needs. To do this, you come up to the More button, and from the drop-down menu, choose Edit Site Layout. Here is where you can customize the header, a footer, specify if you want a sidebar or a horizontal navigation bar. And then you can also come down and actually interact with the sidebar. So if I hover over navigation and click, I now can configure this navigation pane. For example, I can rename it. I can specify how many levels I want to show of the outline. Right now it's showing the initial level and one subpage level. I can have it go 3, or I can make it show all of the sublevels that I may have in my site. If I don't want Google Sites to organize my pages alphabetically, I would deselect this box here where it says automatically organize my navigation. Now I can add pages that I want to be displayed and decide the order in which I want them. I simply click Add Page, expand out the site map, and choose the page I would like to add. We'll add another one in here real quick. Click on a page, and I can then change the order. I can move it up and down the outline. I can choose to make it a subpage or not a subpage. And if I decide, you know what, I don't want the page listed in the sidebar, I can remove it. Notice you can also build in links to other sites or other pages that aren't within your own Google site. Click OK. And you'll notice the sidebar has been reconfigured to fit your needs. You can also add additional boxes and other items into your sidebar by clicking the plus icon. By default, Google gives you a navigation sidebar item, but you can also add a simple text sidebar item. This is great if you want to type in specific terms besides what you named your pages. It's also easy to add external links through a text sidebar item. If you want to show recent activity, you can add this widget in. Your recent activity. A countdown box. This is really handy if you want to put up like a countdown number of days to a deadline, like a field trip or when an assignment is due. Who owns the site? And page authors. Say, let's add the countdown. So now here's that countdown widget. If I click on it, I can now edit and specify the event is field trip and the date takes place on the 13th of March. Click OK. And you'll notice it says 8 days until the field trip. Once you've done configuring the sidebar, click the blue close button to save all your changes. So, if you'd like to customize your navigation sidebar, use the More button and click on Edit Site Layout. Hover over the box that you'd like to configure. and have Google do all the work, some of the work, or none of the work. It's your choice. You decide how you want things displayed. This concludes this tutorial.